الحمد لله رب العالمين، وصلى الله وسلم وبارك على نبينا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم تسليما كثيرا. أما بعد، فما زلنا بفضل الله عز وجل في كتاب شرح العقيدة الواسطية للشيخ الإسلام بن تيمية، شرح للشيخ محمد بن صالح بن عثيمين رحمه الله تعالى. We're still in the book of عقيدة الواسطية بن تيمية, the explanation of بن عثيمين, may Allah have mercy on him and on بن تيمية. And we were dealing last, in our last sitting before the season of Hajj, may Allah accept from those who performed Hajj their Hajj, we were dealing with the توحيد الألوهية, the توحيد of worship, or Allah Azza wa Jal being the object of worship, the only object of worship that the Muslims have, and the only object of worship that the non-Muslims should have, but they fail to fulfill that covenant that they were given way before, that you shall worship Allah alone, because Allah instilled this in our natural inclination, natural disposition. So we had finished explaining ibadah, right? We explained what ibadah was. One second. This thing actually is throwing water on my book. Yes.
You want to come forward or something?
Well, we gotta do something because my book is gonna go bad. I keep thinking I'm spitting. I'm like, I'm not spitting that much, man.
Oh, should we go to the side? Push back?
Yeah, no problem.
Yeah,
it's raining in Saudi, man.
Some smoke is coming.
Smoke?
No, this is cool air. This is cool air. That's good.
That's good.
But some water is coming now.
Yeah. It's been coming now. I told you. معلش الحمد لله. As long as it gives us some cool air, I don't mind. Let it rain.
You're wearing also fit with today.
I am indeed. I thought we were already. I don't know, man. I'm used to another season. Anyways.
In Lebanon, it must be very cold.
It is during the winter season, yes. But we have a moderate, yani nice summer, nice spring, nice fall, nice winter. Everything is okay.
Where?
In Lebanon.
In Lebanon.
No. طيب. So we said, we finished this, defining ibadah. We said, Shaykh al-Islam ibn Taymiyyah rahimahullah qal, al-ibadatu ismun jami'un li kulli ma yuhibbuhu Allah wa yardahu min al-aqwali wal-a'mali al-zahira wal-batina. Shaykh al-Islam ibn Taymiyyah, may Allah have mercy on him, said, worship is an encompassing term that includes everything that Allah loves and is pleased with, from whether it's statements or actions, whether they are apparent or hidden. طيب. An example of that is, for example, the khashya, fearing Allah, is an ibadah of the heart. Inaba, tawakkul, is an ibadah of the heart. This is what is intended by the inner ibadah. طيب. Did we deal already? What was the last note you have?
That ibadah we finished. And then we discussed about Surah Al-Anbiya, verse number 25, worshipping Allah.
Good. Then we did
created a human and jinn to worship him.
There you are.
Surah Al-Dhariyat, verse number 56.
Okay. Then what?
And Surah, if disbeliever ask anything, for example, why...
Tabarakallah feek. I should write a little note from next time. I apologize. This is my mistake. Tab Mumtaz. Yeah, we were dealing with verse in Surah Al-Imran, verse number 18. شَهِدَ اللَّهُ أَنَّهُ لَا إِلَهَ إِلَّا هُوَ وَالْمَلَائِكَةُ وَأُولُو الْعِلْمِ
شَهَدَ.
أيوة, Allah bears witness that there is no God worthy of worship but He, and so do the angels and those who were given knowledge. And the Shaykh said, لَوْ لَمْ يَكُنْ مِنْ فَضْلِ الْعِلْمِ إِلَّا هَذِهِ الْمِنْقَبَةِ حَيْثُ إِنَّ اللَّهَ مَا أَخْبَرَ أَنَّ أَحَدًا شَهِدَ بِأُلُوهِيَتِهِ إِلَّا أُولُو الْعِلْمِ نَسْأَلُ اللَّهَ أَنْ يَجْعَلَنَا مِنْهُمْ. He said, and if there was nothing more virtuous or a position more honorable than that for the scholars and the people of knowledge, that Allah Azza wa Jal included their shahada, and they said that no one bears witness to that except Allah Himself, the angels, and those who were given knowledge, the scholars, we ask Allah Azza wa Jal to make us among them with justice. Then Allah says, ثم قرر هذه الشهادة بقوله لا إله إلا هو العزيز الحكيم. Then Allah emphasized and re-established this testimony by saying at the end of the verse, لا إله إلا هو العزيز الحكيم, no God worthy of worship but Him, the Aziz, the mighty, Al-Hakim, the most wise. Or Aziz could be also the all-powerful. He said, فَهَذَا دَلِيلٌ وَاضِحٌ عَلَى أَنَّهُ لَا إِلَهَ إِلَّا اللَّهِ عَزَّ وَجَلَّ أَشْهَدُ أَنْ لَا إِلَهَ إِلَّا اللَّهِ وَأَنْتُمْ تَشْهَدُونَ أَنْ لَا إِلَهَ إِلَّا اللَّهِ. He said, this is a clear evidence that there is no God worthy of worship but Allah. He said, I bear witness that there is no God worthy of worship but Allah, and you bear witness that there is no God worthy of worship but Allah. هذه شهادة الحق. إذ قال قائل كيف تقرونها مع أن الله تعالى يثبت آلهة غيره مثل قوله تعالى ولا تدع مع الله إلها آخر. The Shaykh said, this is the testimony of truth. But if somebody said, how do you establish that although there were other gods mentioned in the Quran? Remember, we dealt with this actually last time. As Allah says, ولا تدع مع الله إلها آخر, and do not call with Allah, along with Allah, another god. Called God. Allah called it Aliha. 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 Which is from the word. Wa alaykum salam ahlan. No problem, ya Sheikh. ومثل قوله ومن يدعو مع الله إلها آخر لا برهان له به. Whomever calls besides Allah another God, whom he has no evidence for. Or Allah says, فما أغنت عنهم آلهتهم التي يدعون من دون الله من شيء. Verily, it did not suffice them or benefit them their gods that they used to call on besides Allah in anything. ومثل قول إبراهيم أَإِفْكَنْ آلِهَةً دُونَ اللَّهِ تُرِيدُونَ. A lie you make up against Allah. A lie you make up against Allah. Is this what you are seeking? Again, we are trying to establish the fact that Allah Azza wa Jal called them in the Quran آلِهَة. Gods, gods, gods. More than one occasion. So how do you bring a relation between that? We are saying there is no God worthy of worship but Allah, yet Allah says in the Quran that there are other gods. So if somebody brought this shubuha to you, this doubtful affair, how do you respond? The Shaykh says, فالجواب أن ألوهيته أن ألوهية ما سوى الله ألوهية باطلة مجرد تسمية. As Allah says, إن هي إلا أسماء سميتموها أنتم وأباؤكم ما أنزل الله بها من سلطان. He said, the uluhiyya, meaning the attribute of being deserving of worship, to all the other gods besides Allah is a false one. It's false. As Allah says, it's only a name, a title given to it. You only call it a god. You understand what I'm saying? For example, just to make it easy, you have a cell phone, and they sell in the store for little kids a cell phone, but that has candy. It's really not a cell phone, it just looks like a phone. You cannot use it, but you call it a cell phone. You tell your son, bring your little cell phone. I have my cell phone, you have your cell phone. If he was to use a cell phone, there's no Irsal, there's no Jawal, there's no mobile, there's nothing. It's a candy, there's candy inside. But they call it, so it's just a name. It's given the name of a cell phone. These are given the name of gods, because the people take them as gods. In reality, they didn't create, they didn't sustain, and they do not deserve worship. So they're not really gods, they're false gods. But they have the title of a god. You understand me? That's why Allah says, "In hiya illa asma'un samaytumuha." Surah Al-Najm. Verily, it is nothing but names that you have given. Antum wa abakum, you and your forefathers. Ma anzal Allahu biha min sultan. Allah did not reveal any authority for that. No authority was given for you to claim or to make other gods with Allah Azza wa Jal. فألوهيتها باطلة. وهي إن عبدت وتؤلها إليها من ضل وهي وإن عبدت وتألى إليها من ضل فإنها ليست أهلا لأن تعبد فهي آلهة معبودة لكنها آلهة باطلة ذلك بأن الله هو الحق وأن ما يدعون من دونه الباطل. We continue إن شاء الله. So the Shaykh said, so this claim that it's a god is false. And this particular, these gods, although they are being worshipped and the people are devoting themselves to these gods, it is really not worthy of being worshipped. It is worshipped indeed, but it is in falsehood. Yani people still worship it. It doesn't deserve to be worshipped. Yes, yet the people worship it, and that worship is nothing but falsehood. And this is the verse that is usually the refutation. ذلك بأن الله هو الحق وأن ما يدعون من دونه الباطل. This is in Surah Luqman, verse 30. This is the way to answer this. Hala, the Shaykh elaborated. But the clear response for someone who tells you, how do you bring relation between Allah saying there are gods in the Quran and the fact that there's La ilaha illallah? You say, Allah told us there are other gods, but Allah told us Verily, this is because Allah is the God in truth. Allah is the Ilah, truthfully. And all the ones that they call besides Him are false. Batil, are falsehood. So this is how we respond to this. There are other gods, but they don't deserve it. But the only one who is a God and who deserves it is Allah Azza wa Jalla. He's the true Ilah. And all the other ones are false. The Shaykh said, وَهَذَانِ النَّوْعَانِ مِنْ أَنْوَاعِ التَّوْحِيدِ لَا يَجْحَدُهُمَا وَلَا يُنْكِرْهُمَا أَحَدٌ مِنْ أَهْلِ الْقِبْلَةِ الْمُنْتَسِبِينَ إِلَى الْإِسْلَامِ. He said, these two kinds of tawheed, because we already learned two kinds of tawheed, ya akhwan. We learned the tawheed of rububiyya, the tawheed of lordship, Allah being the creator, the sustainer, the sovereign, إلى آخره. And we learned the tawheed of uluhiyya, worship, meaning Allah, once we establish that Allah is the only creator, only sustainer, so we don't dedicate worship to none but Him. The Shaykh said these two kinds of tawheed, no one rejects them or denies them among the people of the Qibla, meaning all those who turn towards Kaaba, all the Muslims. No one rejects them. There's no problem with that. Otherwise they will become non-Muslims, inevitably, right? لأن الله تعالى موحد بالربوبية والألوهية. Because Allah really is given the oneness in terms of lordship and in terms of ألوهية. لكن حصل فيما بعد أن من الناس من ادعى ألوهية أحدا من البشر. But yet, among the Muslims, there were some people who claimed that there were others who were also gods. And he was a human. كغلاة الرافضة مثلا الذين يقولون إن عليا إله. Such as the Shia, Rafida. They're called Rafida because the Rafida means from the word Raft. Raft is to reject. They're called Rafida because they are rejectors. What did they reject? They reject the Khilafah of Abu Bakr and Umar. Because they believe that they were kuffar and that they stole the Khilafah from Ali radiallahu anhu. So they were called the Rafida because of that. There's another interpretation why they were called the Rafida, but this is one of them. So which is in common days the Shia. During the time of Ali, they came and told Ali, you are a god. أنت إله. He burnt them. رضي الله عنه. That's kufr. Right there. You come tell a human, that's worse than a Christian now. Telling Jesus is a god.
They reject Muhammad's prophet also?
Huh?
They reject Muhammad's prophet also?
No, during his time, this was after Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم, after he had passed away. أيوة. كما صنع زعيمهم عبد الله بن سبأ. As their leader claimed, his name was Abdullah ibn Sabah. This is the one who started the Shia. Just in case you're interested, his name is Abdullah ibn Sabah. Abdullah the son of Sabah. حيث جاء إلى علي علي بن أبي طالب رضي الله عنه وقال له أنت الله حقا أعوذ بالله. When he came to Ali, the son of Abi Talib, may Allah be pleased with him, and told him, you are the Allah in truth, not just أنت إله أنت الله حقا. In truth. لكن عبد الله بن سبأ أصله يهودي دخل في الإسلام بدعوة التشيع لآل البيت. But in truth, عبد الله بن سبأ, that guy was a Jew. He was a Jewish man. This is how the hypocrites used to be. So he came into Islam in order to destroy Islam from within. أيوة. The Shia were initiated by the Jews. That's why you find often a lot of weird things that are happening today in the political world, where they may seem to be against each other, but only Allah knows the reality and their affiliations with each other. The Shia man, among all the deviant groups, they are absolutely the worst. The Shia have caused more damage to the Ahl Sunnah than you can imagine. They have transgressed. They seek nearness to Allah by cursing the Sahaba. I've seen it with my own eyes. Uqsum billah, he will come on the minbar, he will curse Abu Huraira, curse Abu Bakr as-Siddiq, curse Umar, curse Aisha, and he will cry with khushu', and they will all cry with him. They seek nearness to Allah by cursing the Sahaba, calling them all kuffar except six or a few number that they believe remain Muslims. Then they claim all the other Muslims, they became kuffar. A'udhu billah. You must be crazy. And the Prophet ﷺ said, if I was to take a close friend among the people, it would be Abu Bakr. But verily, it is only Allah. If I was to take one among the humans, it would be Abu Bakr. And we know the virtue of Abu Bakr. You come and call him a kafir. Anyways, a Jew is who started the Shia. His name is Abdullah ibn Sabah. And he entered into Islam with the intention to glorify the Ahlul Bayt, the family of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. So Ali was a relative of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. So he raised him above his status. ليفسد على